Hello, I'm Joseph Coehlo, author of Luna Loves Art, illustrated by Fiona Lumbers, and I'm so pleased to be joining you today for the International Literature Festival Dublin. Hope you enjoy. Luna Loves Art, by me, Joseph Coehlo, illustrated by Fiona Lumbers. It's such a pleasure today to be sharing this story with you for the International Literature Festival Dublin and the National Gallery of Ireland. Let's go and see what art Luna discovers. Ooh, right at the start, on the end pages of the book, there are lots of real works of art. Works of art that exist in the world. Works of art that you can see in art galleries all over the world, or indeed find online. We'll come back to some of these a bit later. Luna loves art. Today she is going on a school trip. School trip backpack? Check. School trip lunchbox? Check. School trip instant camera? Click. Here's Luna and her dad in their front room. And if you see, have a look on the walls, there are lots of works of art. Maybe you can have a look wherever you are now, have a look up on the walls to see if there's any works of art that you can see near you. Dad drops Luna off at the school gates. Miss Rosa is waiting with the register. Luna's mum is a parent helper. Finn is alone. Today the class is going to the art gallery. The whole class is excited. The gallery is the biggest building Luna has ever seen. But Finn doesn't care. Finn is looking down. They start off in a huge room, full of amazing, massive things, full of colour, full of shapes. Look at all the art, says Luna. Finn is looking up. Do you know what we can do, guys? We can go right back to the beginning to find out the names of some of these works of art. Let's have a look. So there's the big spidery one. Here it is. And this is by Louise Bourgeois, and it's called Mammon. And there's also a blue dog. And that's by Jeff Koons, and it's called Balloon Dog. How lovely. Miss Rosa takes the class to the Impressionist and Post-Impressionist rooms. Vincent van Gogh's Sunflowers has paint so thick that the flowers look alive. Finn goes to touch it. Stop, says Luna. You're not allowed to touch the paintings. She's quite right, isn't she? You're not allowed to touch them. You can look, but you shouldn't touch them. Miss Rosa hands out some clipboards, paper and pencils. Luna does a sketch, scribble. Finn scrunches up Luna's picture. Hey, says Luna. Miss Rosa takes Finn aside. Why is he so mean, says Luna. Maybe he needs a friend, says Mum. Miss Rosa takes the class to the abstract paintings room. Kazimir Malevich's Black Square is all edged black and cracked. A nighttime robbed of stars, a phone waiting to ring. Finn's mouth is open. Do you want to sketch with me, Finn? Asks Luna. Finn is silent. That's a lovely idea, isn't it, that Luna's had? Because there are lots of children that you can see doing some sketches, sketching some of the work that they see. Next time you visit an art gallery, maybe you could take a pencil and some paper with you, and you could have a go at sketching some of the things that you see on the walls. Miss Rosa asks the class, describe what is happening in Henry Rousseau's Surprised. There's a scaredy cat tiger in the jungle, laughs Luna. Finn roars at the painting. The wind is thrashing, the clouds are dark, the tiger is angry, but inside he is cold and wet. He wanders the jungle, staying in different places all the time. The tiger is scared and alone and needs a home. Mum leads Finn to a quiet corner. Luna follows. Henry Moore's family group is big and bronze. Luna takes a photo. Click. Families don't look like that, says Finn. Mum says, some families look like that, some do not. Some families are related, some are not. Some families are together, some are apart. There are lots of different families. Like all, this different art. Miss Rosa takes the class to a dark room, full of lights and sounds. We can touch the art, beams Luna. It's incredible, shouts Finn. Everyone looks different under the pulsing lights. One big, colourful family. Luna takes a photo. Click. Look, this page is a bit special because there's some lovely reflective bits on this page. That wonderful piece of art. Miss Rosa takes the class to the art gallery shop. There are erasers, pencils and badges, Henry Moore keyrings, posters of sunflowers and black squares, postcards of tigers, toys that light up and flash. Luna gives Finn a photo. Finn gives Luna a drawing. And there's Finn. He's got a little drawing that he's done whilst at the gallery. How lovely. And Luna's got a photo that she's taken. That's lovely. Luna and Finn laugh on the bus back to school, take photos of the sights, and talk about all the art they remember. Luna and Finn love school trips. Luna and Finn love art. And look, all the kids are smiling as they go back to school from visiting the art gallery. And maybe Luna's adventure with Finn might inspire you to visit your local art gallery next time you can. Maybe you'll take a camera to take some photos. Maybe you'll take some paper and a pencil so you can do some sketching. Maybe you'll describe with whoever you're with what you see in the photos, just like Luna does in Luna Loves Art.
Hello, I'm Fiona Lumbers and I am the illustrator of Luna Loves Art. Now in the story, Luna and her classmates go to visit the art gallery and together they get to see lots of different types of art. Paintings and sculptures, all different shapes and sizes, and there's even a room with lights and sounds. And they have a wonderful time exploring. Are you looking forward to going back to the art galleries and museums? Because I know I am. I get so much inspiration from looking at other people's pieces of art and they make me want to make art of my own. And so I thought today it would be really interesting to find a piece of art from the National Gallery of Ireland's collection that we can make a piece of art together based on an element of that painting. So the painting I chose is called The Goose Girl and it's by an artist called Stanley Royle. And I love this painting for lots of reasons and you might recognise it if you've been to the National Gallery of Ireland. It's really beautiful. It's got a wonderful texture, lots of different marks and colours and shapes. And it's also just really tranquil and peaceful. And I absolutely love it. So I thought it would be really interesting today if together I showed you how to make a collage based on some of the flowers that you can see in this painting. So today I'm going to show you how to make your own bluebell collage that will look something like this. So a collage is where you make a piece of art made out of cut or ripped pieces of paper. And there's a collage actually in Luna Loves Art. If I flick to the right page, if I go all the way to the back of the book, this piece here by Henri Matisse is a massive collage made of large pieces of ripped and cut pieces of paper. I get inspiration from looking at lots of different types of art, but also what's all around me. So what I like to do is always take a sketchbook out with me, whether it's at the art gallery or the museum, or just when I'm out and about on a walk. And if I see something that I love or that I find interesting, then I'll make a note of it or I'll do a quick scribble in my sketchbook. And then when I get home, I might explore that further and think about how I want to make that into a piece of art. So I'd really recommend when you're going out and about, maybe the next time you visit the art gallery or a museum, to take an art kit along with you, or a sketchbook, or a piece of paper to make some notes on. It's just so that when you're looking at everything that's around you, you can note down what it is that you found really interesting and then make a piece of art based on that. So, without further ado, I'm now going to show you how to make your very own collage. I hope you enjoy it. Hi, so today I thought it would be really cool to make a piece of art based on a painting that's in the National Gallery of Ireland's collection. And I was inspired to make a painting using a technique called collage, which if you've read Luna Loves Art, if I find the page, this painting here by an artist named Henri Matisse called The Snail is a really big piece of art that's made using lots of different coloured pieces of paper stuck to the surface to create the image. So I thought it would be really interesting to find a wonderful painting from the gallery's collection and to base a piece of art on that. So the painting that I chose to look at from the National Gallery of Ireland's collection is this wonderful painting here called The Goose Girl by an artist named Stanley Royle. And you may recognise it if you've been to the National Gallery in Ireland before. And if not, you could have a look online and see if you could spot it on there in the gallery's collection. Now, what I really love about this painting is all the different colours and textures that are within the forest, especially the bluebells, which at the moment, if you go out for a walk, you're likely to spot some bluebells out and about, because I saw this yesterday. I took this photograph yesterday when I was out for a walk with my son. And I thought, oh, it would be wonderful to make a piece of art based on the bluebells within this painting. So, what you will need to make your collage is to pick out some of these colours and then see if you can find some old scraps of paper, maybe in a magazine or some old wrapping paper, anything you've got lying around at home, and pick out some of these colours, which I've done here. I found some in my scrap paper drawer, so that we can make a collage of some of the flowers within the painting. If you don't have any coloured paper, what you can also do is just get some white paper and get some pens or paints or pastels and make some different colours to use to then cut out for the collage. So I'm going to move these over to one side and get a sheet of paper. So if you've got a sheet of A4 paper, that would be wonderful. And then you'll also need something to cut with. So I've got some scissors, or you could ask an adult to help you cut out shapes, and something to glue with, and something to draw with. And then all we need to do to start with is to think about the shape of a bluebell. Now, if I've come back to this painting here, this photograph, I mean, they're kind of shaped like a sausagey bell. So a really cool way to draw a bluebell is to just draw a big loop like so. And then at the bottom, we're going to do three triangles. So we'll go 1, 2, 3. And that's our bluebell shape. And then once you've drawn a few different ones, you can use different colour paper. So you've got some different shades of bluebell. So you could use some blue or some lilac, some purpley blue, and then just cut them all out. So here's a few I cut out earlier on. Once you've cut out your bluebells, put them to one side, and then find some green pieces of paper, like so. And then we're going to cut out the stems and the leaves. And to do that, you can just put some paper together like this, and then just cut some strips, like so. They don't have to be very neat. You can just do different shapes and sizes. I'm doing them all together just to save time, but you can take your time with this. Maybe some leaf shapes, like so. You can also tear the paper so you have a more bobbly edge, like that. Just cut out some different colours, pieces. You could do, if you wanted to do a more textured background, you could cut out or rip out some squares like so. So there's some I ripped off earlier on. And what we're going to do is build up our pieces of paper to create a collage. So if you position your bits of paper on the page and get an idea of where you want things to go. So I might want a leaf coming out here, and then one coming out here, and then possibly a torn bit of paper at the bottom to kind of make the grass, maybe a longer one for the top bluebells to be hanging off of. Once you've worked out where you want all your pieces to go, you just get your glue stick and you stick them down. So here's one that I did a little while ago. So as you can see, I've just cut out some bits like I just showed you and then just stuck them on. I also found some bits of confetti, so I thought, well, they're quite interesting shapes, so I'll stick them on too. So once you've done that, if you think that's all enough that you need, then that's fine. And if not, then you can add some more bits to build up a background like so. Maybe some bigger bits of torn paper to build up the bottom of your image. And that's stage one. So once we've done that stage, we'll get our bluebells that we cut out at the beginning. And thinking about how plants grow, the flowers stick up in all different directions. So once you've stuck down your underpiece, you can then place on your bluebells where you think they will go on the painting. And you can just play around with that and see where you think they look good and which colours look nice next to each other, like so. So here's my bluebells in my little woodland glade, like in the Goose Girl painting. Yeah, I think that looks quite nice. So then what I will do is get my glue stick, get some glue on the back of all the bits of paper, and then stick them down and end up with something a bit like this. So there's my bluebell collage. I've also added a few small yellow flowers, which I just cut out by drawing some bumps and cutting around them. And then maybe like we could add some more. We could build up the picture further by adding some more little scraps of paper like so. Once you've done that, that's your basic collage. And what you can do then is you can either leave it like that, or you can think, oh, maybe there'll be a creature living in my collage. And then either with a pencil or by using the paper, you could add that to your picture. So perhaps I'll have a snail crawling along this leaf like so. So I'll pop him on there. And then maybe there's some more little bits of blue in the background like this, and I can scribble them on. Or a butterfly up here. You could either draw a butterfly, or you could rip out some lovely pieces of paper and make a beautiful butterfly to go on your collage. So really, it's up to you what you do with it. And if you don't want to do bluebells, you can use this technique to make any picture that you might get inspired by, either at the art gallery or at the museum, or just when you're out and about. If you see something that you think looks really interesting, make a little note of it and then go home and play around with paper, because it's a really wonderful way to make a piece of art. So I hope you really enjoy making your collages. And what you could do when you finished is you could get a grown-up to print off a Luna printout from the Anderson Press website and make your own piece of art to go in Luna's art gallery and then colour in Luna. Thanks for joining me today, and have lots of fun making art and making collages. Bye for now.